Ah, yeah, I can see.
Yeah, I
Somebody
painted
posted
the wrong link in a meetup, so I figured it out, went there and connected, placed a message there that we are here. So I hope now pretty much everybody moved to this side. So Christian, it's
okay.
Your stage.
Thanks, Augustine. Then let's start. As you can see already on your screen, we are still kind of wrapping up for the session that we have on the 22nd of December, our Christmas session. You can see we have lots of great speakers. Feel free to connect to that session. Looking forward to that. Just some housekeeping for now. The regular ones on this call know, this will be recorded, and the recording is in progress. If you don't wish to be recorded, just feel free to drop off now, and you can watch the recording later on one of our channels. You can see the channels that you can subscribe to here in our meetup group, to the LinkedIn group, or YouTube. And if there's anything that you would like to know or would like to contribute to this, please feel free to reach out to one of the organizers, Augustine or me, via LinkedIn or Twitter. And any suggestions on what session we should present next, or whatever the topic you would like to see, please feel free to reach out and add us. As for the upcoming sessions, on the 24th, we have Chris Wagner with the Data God session and how to become one of them. The 12th, the 1st of December, will be Michael with a session on Tabular Editor and the Best Practice Analyzer. And on the 15th, so 2 weeks after, we will have Alexander with 5 ways of misrepresenting your data. So you don't want to miss out on that. As for today, I don't want to keep you any further from the actual learning session. We'll have Thomas with the session about sharing is growing. And with that, I'd like to hand over to Thomas. And thanks for being here. And we're looking forward to hearing from you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Christian, for this introduction. And thank you for giving the chance to me to talk about this sharing thing and what does it take and need. And now I will start to try to present my screen. And I guess now you should see that I'm using Power BI and go to my first screen and enter the presentation mode. And hopefully I can't now. Sorry. So I guess you are seeing my screen right now, right?
Yes, we can see it.
Perfect. So it's one of the mysteries what I really need to share. As I call it, most of the time I call it artifacts in Power BI, and why sometimes it doesn't work, and why I need this license, what license do I need, and things like that. So I want to cover this in this session. Meaning, so there's a little introduction and why I consider sharing is so important. And then I also prepared a little proof, because sometimes it's simply not that clear. And then I provide, let's say, more details why this is necessary. And sometimes it's more, so we will go to it. And so now I'm, let's say, almost 25 plus years doing analytical or implementing analytical solutions. Most of the time of this 25 years using Microsoft Data Platform, and the last 5 to 6 years I was using focusing on Power BI and more or things like that. I also did Power View implementation embedded in, this was my first Power BI project using Power View and SharePoint, as it was not already called Power BI, it's dedicated application. So I stick to it. It's still fascinating. Currently, I'm working as a solution architect at Munich Re. It's a large reinsurance company based in Munich in Germany. One of my favorite things is creating DAX statements, and this also Phil Seamark and I wrote a book about what can be done using DAX. So maybe some interesting use cases there, and all this Microsoft thing also earned me the Microsoft Data Platform MVP status. So this is about me. If you want to get in touch, I share the presentations. You can write an email or get in touch on Twitter, LinkedIn, whatever you want. So why is sharing so important? If I want to explain something, I my first address is to go to Wikipedia and find a definition of something that I want to explain. And what I like here is that it's a basic component of human interaction and is responsible for strengthening social ties and ensuring a person's well-being. So this is what sharing is defined in this way on Wikipedia. There are other explanations, but I love the idea that it's about a basic component of human interaction. So sharing a report, for example, means providing access to this resource that other colleagues can interact with it. And it strengthens our social ties, because if we are using the same report, we are seeing the same numbers, meaning we are also talking about the same things. And this, let's say, in a certain way, can be also translated to strengthening social ties. And personally, I consider learning very important. Learning new things is very important to me. So if I learn something, then I would say it's a factor that has something to do with my person's well-being. So, and for this reason, I consider sharing also and learning and this is why I say sharing means also we grow, because we are able to achieve things more easily if we are doing them together. And this somehow doing things together means at least we have to head for the same target and thing like that. And so this is why I say sharing is also the starting point for learning and growing. So this is my simple explanation for that. But next to that, so here we are. But so this is this is the explanation of the content of the session here. the sharing thing is, as it works now, is in place, let's say, for three and a half years now. And still, there are questions about why I do need this license, why, what does it mean? So for this reason, I always find some questions about this. And because I find sharing so important, I put together this slides for, and now I'm honored to be presenting the slides here, talking about sharing. There's a takeaway. If I consider Power BI Desktop at the self-service analytical powerhouse, whatever, Power BI Desktop is a free piece of software. You can download it for free. It does not come with any costs. So you design beautiful reports, and if you are not and have to share your reports that you are designing and share your insights that you gain from your data visualizations, it has no costs because you can use it on your own. There are two different aspects where Microsoft is asking for money. And this one topic is, if you want to share, then you have to pay money. I come to this in a little bit later, what this means. And the other aspect is this premium per capacity or premium per user licensing fee will also come in place. So what this means is, it's about accessing or sharing content with user, you have to pay always, except one situation. And this premium per capacity or premium per user is nothing that it does not change your Power BI Desktop. This Power BI premium capacity or premium per user enables additional features inside your workspace. So if you have one of these premium per capacity or premium per user licenses assigned, then you are able to use different capabilities of a workspace, whatever that may be. I will talk about this a little bit later. But it does not mean, it does not change your Power BI Desktop experience. So, and this is sometimes, this, I guess this is not clear, and maybe because I have dealt with it over a couple of years, and I assume that I now have an idea what is required to share, what license do I need, and where do I get these licenses? But it's still and sometimes a book with unanswered questions, it seems. Oh, start sharing means it's easy. To share a report or a dashboard, a paginated report. This is what I mean with sharing an artifact. I want to share an existing report with a single user. So this is share. Sometimes I call it instant sharing, and sometimes, and this is in has to be compared with adding a member to a workspace or providing access to a Power BI app. So this is have some instant sharing or provide access to a workspace or provide permissions to access the content of an app. And why do I want to do this or that? This sometimes is, we have to consider that whenever I invite or add a user playing a role in my workspace, then this user is able to alter the content inside a workspace. So this is something that I maybe do not want to do. Also he is able to alter content in my workspace, but he is also able to see all the content inside my workspace. And maybe this is what I do want to avoid, because I just want to share a single report with a certain user and do not want him to allow see everything what inside the workspace. The same is valid for the app. Whatever is inside the app, if I provide access to the app, this user is able to see the whole content, meaning all the reports and things like that. Of course, not all the data. If I have something implemented like role level security and things like that, so then it does not show, or the user will not be able to see all the data, but all the content, meaning all the visuals, because it's not possible to restrict the content based on different roles. So it's about instant sharing or adding a member to a workspace or assigning permissions to access the content of an app. And it's also still not clear that I do need. So Microsoft asked us for money if you want to share. And it's now I will show some screenshots, a process of how this sharing of a single artifact works. And whenever there's, because I have these screenshots, I try to access or provide access to the report. I have a different role. Whenever you see this green lady, then this person, or this is from a perspective where a pro license is assigned. If you see a red person, I'm trying to access the content with a user that has free license assigned. And now here we go. Sharing is easy, because you just hit this little icon here, and then I'm instantly able to share this report, because this icon tells me that this is a report here, this blue one with a little bar chart, column chart. I can share it, and I can do it as just can do it, share a report if I have a pro license assigned. So sharing means if I want to share something, this single artifact, then it's necessary that the person who wants to share has a pro license assigned. If I'm doing that, so maybe here, so it's about Thomas. This is my real name. And here you see, I, Thomas, want to share a report with Tom. So most of the people that know me a little bit longer call me Tom. So it's really two different persons, two different identities in my same, or in my tiny Power BI tenant that I own. A little bit more people, but one has a free license assigned and one has a pro license assigned. Green means pro license, red means free license. And this is the first dialogue that after I hit this one here, this little icon, this is the dialogue that appears when I add a user. I come to this, what this means here, I come to this a little later on. So I just add a little message, or add a user, can add a little message and then just hit send. And now I shared my report with Tom. Tom receives an email that tells him that Thomas has shared a Power BI report customer, controls the retail report with me. And if I open this email, there's this open this report. And if I hit this orange yellow button, then of course, I see if I hit this button as Tom, free license assigned, it tries to bring me to the report inside Power BI service. So I authenticate with my Tom account using, and then I see this message. This message tells me that I cannot see the content of this report because I do not have, or Tom does not have the proper permissions to the underlying data set. Okay, so this is not because I just have the free license assigned. This is because I need to have some kind to access, some permission to access the underlying data set of this report. So this is the first message that can appear if the person who shares did not provide the proper permission in advance. Most of the time, this is already taken care of. So this is the could be message. And back again as Thomas, and I add the person who wants to access this report needs to have permission on the data set. I'm Thomas, adding the changing the permissions to this data set, providing read access, and so done. Now back as the red one, meaning Tom. I am getting asked. So unfortunately, there's a screenshot missing. I'm so sorry. No, it's perfect. Because I have a free license, red person has a free license assigned, and I want to open a report that has been shared with me. Power BI service tells me, okay, it looks like I wanted to access a shared report. We have given you a free trial of Power BI paid features for 60 days. So this can be considered cool or not. I consider it most of the time, it depends thing. So Microsoft Power BI service realizes that Tom Red, does not have the sufficient permissions or license that is required to access a shared report. So this basically is proof that the person who wants to share and the person who wants to access a shared content both need a paid license, meaning at least Power BI Pro. And this automatic providing the paid features, I consider it not cool because it hassles. If I look at my settings inside Power BI as Tom, then it says me, okay, and now I have a license type Pro and 59 days left because it started somewhere, and I take the screenshot as I started this, and I consider this not cool because for a couple of time I'm working with larger clients, and who have their own provisioning, purchasing process of things like that. And for this reason, it can be sometimes a little bit confusing if people have a pro license and now they are able to use this. And after a while, let's say after 70 days, they want to access this report again. And then they realize, oh, it doesn't work any longer. So why? And it starts a lot of confusion at the people who have this trial license automatically assigned. And this is just one of the topics that has to be considered. So one reason I do not consider it cool. And if your organization has a process how certain license types have been assigned to users, and it contradicts this process if it happens automatically. And of course, because information data sharing and creating amazing content is so important, I also say it's necessary that the users should have provisioned all the necessary means, meaning a Power BI desktop installation, a pro or premium per user license assigned as fast as possible, but it should not be happen automatically. But I want to stay because I also am a Power BI service administrator. I want to know who has a pro license and why, maybe, why does he ask for this and things like that. I want to be ahead of the process. I want to be make sure that this process is somehow met and not that is contradicted by automatic addition, automatically providing this trial license. And this I can, as here there is this setting inside the Power BI tenant where I here for this demonstration I enabled this for the whole organization, that everyone who gets an email that someone else has been shared a report, a dashboard, or paginated report will automatically be assigned a pro license trial version. I enabled this for this demonstration, but actually, my recommendation is please do yourself a favor and disable that. So this is then if it's disabled, this trial licensing will not happen. But there's another thing, and this unfortunately is also maybe contradict the self your compliance things and what your purchase process is. It's also possible that a user is able to buy his own pro license or whatever is needed. And maybe this, because you have a budget that you want to spend because it's a budget. You like the idea that people who want to use these licenses are able to buy their own licenses inside your organization. Of course, I'm talking about people inside your organization. You like that? I think it is not a good idea to enable or disable enable self-service sign-up and purchasing options. And this is also here a link. These links, I will open it right now. What? What's going on? I have to leave the presentation. Sorry. So this explains somehow this tenant setting, sorry, this tenant setting, where is it? It's one of the first. So here you're in the tenant setting, sorry for scrolling. So this is so it's on this side where it's explained how you can disable or enable this self-assignment of the trial version. And there's another link in this presentation that explains how you can disable or enable self-service is of course a good idea, but it also here explains why you may want to disable this self-service purchase things. And I met all these reasons here in the past why it's a good idea to disable this self-service assignment, self-service purchasing in large organizations. So unfortunately, sometimes you have to use PowerShell or Azure AD and Microsoft 365 to enable or disable this self-service thing. But maybe you want to consider, do you want to buy, allow your colleagues to buy their licenses on their own, or do you want to have a process? And this is what I mean by stay ahead of this process, but allow users to request what they need to do to tackle their task. Yes. So, for example, we implemented a little form that allows the user to ask for a pro license, and this is automatically approved, and the user becomes a pro license assigned automatically, because we want to provide the means what he needs to do his amazing work as fast as possible. But we do it, and not everyone is allowed to do it for himself. So this is a little bit seems maybe contradictory that fast as possible, but create a process and disallow people to spend their own money. But also, I consider this very important that you could, that you at least think for a moment what you want. And there's more details. And these details are from one of the best articles available, in, from my point of view, in the Power BI or in the official Microsoft documentation. From my perspective, this is the one of the best articles there. So here you find this article. And this article states you need Power BI Pro or Premium per user when I want to share content inside or outside my organization, meaning I want to share this report with someone outside of my organization, then this is called external sharing. This is possible. But if I want to do this, I need a pro license. And the second point here is your recipients also need a Power BI Pro or Premium per user license, unless the content is in a premium capacity. This is not that true, but nevertheless, it says I need a pro license if I'm either the sender or the recipient. And this is like, I just copy pasted this because it's there for, even if this article now says it's has been updated yet, okay, fun, yesterday, but it's there for years. And for this reason, I consider this the one of the most important articles in this documentation. So where you can share, what does it mean? So this is also important to understand from where the sharing starts. And this means, where's my Power BI tenant? Here we go. Here we are in my little tenant. And there's a workspace. And this workspace is called sharing. And here you find this little icon that allows you to start the sharing. Maybe, I guess you are aware of this, that a workspace is a container of artifacts, reports, data sets, data flows, whatever you can publish to a workspace or is inside a workspace, or create a data flow inside a workspace. It's a container of objects. And this is important if you want to share this report with instant sharing with a single or a couple, just a couple of users. This is where the sharing starts. And because this is my workspace and not an app, if I open this great report, it's a great report showing a table. It's important to realize that this now is my URL that will be sent to the user, to this Tom guy. It says something, Power BI, blah, 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 groups, blah, blah, blah. This groups is important because if I start the sharing from inside a workspace, a user is accessing this report hosted and residing in a workspace. This is important to understand that someone who is accessing content residing in a workspace needs to be a member of that workspace. And this requires being a member of a workspace requires a pro license. Otherwise, it's not possible to access this this content. So, and now, if this workspace, unfortunately, I'm not able to afford owning a premium per capacity license, because now this we see this is just a pro license because this funny diamond is missing. And now I'm often asked questions because I have premium, this is my report is in a premium or is in a workspace backed by a premium per capacity licensing plan. I share my report with a user and now this user is asked or needs a pro license. This is so simple because it's inside a workspace. If I create an app right now, then what really happens is this report, sorry, just hit cancel one more time. This report, if I'm saying that this report should be part by this simple icon here, it's if and then if I create this app, yes, it can take a while, hopefully it will not take everywhere. I go to the app now, right now, of course. So now I want to use this amazing report once again. I want to I want to share this report or embed this. It's important to understand that if I now I want to, for example, if I want to embed this report in a SharePoint online site, I get a different link because now it's called this link here is different. It's about groups, me, apps, things like that. And now if I'm start the sharing from here, the user, the recipient of the invitation to access this content is accessing a different instance hosted on a different location inside an app. And if I share this report from inside an app, and this app is backed by a premium per capacity, yes, then it's true. The user does not have to have a pro license because someone else paid this by purchasing the premium per capacity plan. Someone other paid for me, so it's possible to access the content that has been shared with me without the need for having a pro license is assigned. But this is only the only case when this workspace is backed by a premium per capacity users license, not premium per capacity license plan. Then it's possible to access this report without having the need for a license. But if I'm starting the sharing here from inside the workspace, the content is hosted inside a workspace. Being a member of a workspace requires a pro license. So this, even if this workspace is also backed by the same, of course, capacity, a premium per capacity plan, it's not possible to use this for free. And I hopefully this is also about it has to be considered from where I do, from where do I start the sharing, and this is what this is meant here. Where you can share, you can share reports, dashboard for my workspace, okay. Other than my workspace, if you have an admin or member role, so this is detailed because it does not say about the licensing, just an admin or a member, a user that has been assigned the admin or member role can share, not a contributor, except I can, oops, sorry for that. Hopla, wrong direction. Except if I have to assign the contributor also the green share permission. I can share from Power, from start the sharing from inside Power BI mobile apps. Okay, perfect. I can't start sharing reports from inside Power BI desktop. The only thing that I can share something is share the PBIX file, but I'm pretty sure that you do not want to share your PBIX file with your hundreds of users. So this is simply not a good idea. So first I have to publish a report into a workspace, and then I can start the sharing from there, either from my workspace or an app workspace. But it's that I always have to consider that this may require role license. Are there any questions until now? I am not able to see the screen, or are you still there? Are there still people in the chat? I just come pause it for a short moment. So no question at all. So okay, then I continue. Sorry. If you have a question, please unmute yourself and ask the question immediately. So going back to my presentation. So to whom can I share? It's about the dialogue from the beginning. I come to this a little bit. I will show this dialogue in a second again. I can share people inside my organization, meaning with everyone or to specific people as I have chosen, as I, Thomas, have chosen the Tom guy. And what does this really mean? People with existing access. So this sounds funny, because this option dialogue is funny, but this then just creates an URL, because there's a report, people have access to this report already, however, and I changed the report, adding new visuals, correcting wrong duck statements and things like that. I just want to have the link once again, and just send out a little email. Hey guys, I have changed all the issues, added some visuals and things like that. So it does not change any existing permissions to this existing report. This is also something that I guess should be taken in, you should consider what does it mean, or should I check the boxes or uncheck the boxes. It's about this one here. Now I've started the sharing once again, select one, so what does it mean? Specific people, yes, of course. And now, what does this mean here? Allow recipients to share this report. Meaning, do I want as a report owner that all the people I have been provided access by this share link, do I want them to allow to share this report once again to other people? Maybe this is a good idea because then you do not have to share it once again to thousands of people if they're asking for. But maybe you want to, you think, okay, this is not a good idea because maybe it's also, I'm not finally implemented all this row level, object level security. And now if someone who is accessing this report is maybe seeing more data as he should see. So for maybe this, you might uncheck this box. And then this one here, allow recipients to build content with the data associated with the report. I'm not sure if you are aware of this data set permissions. This is what it's here. Sorry. There's something that is called manage permissions and security. Security is this object or row level security thing, meaning here I can add users to a certain role. This role then will allow or disallow to see certain elements. Manage permissions is how a certain user is able to access this data set. And now I'm asked to, now I can add reshare, meaning this user is able to reshare access to this underlying data set. Add build means this user is able to create his own reports based on this data set. It does not mean he can change the underlying data set in a way that it will break. This user then, if he has his build permission, then this user is able to create his own reports and also add, for example, measures, but is not able to add calculated columns to this data set because this would calculated columns would dramatically change an already existing table. So this is not possible if this user has built permissions. This is what is meant by sorry, if I'm here in the report saying start the sharing, selecting or try to do I need or want to have all these users the possibility to create their own reports, meaning also measures based on this data set. This is what this really means here. And I consider it a good idea to uncheck this checkboxes most of the time. Unfortunately, this is the default. And for this reason, I also say do not share a single report because then you have every time you have to or a report or dashboard, then you always have to uncheck because I think it's a good idea not to provide these permissions, meaning resharing the report or build your own reports. Most of the time, I do not want this. And for this reason, I also maybe you want to check what's happening here in the permissions if you are creating an app. do you want them using the build permissions or not? Make a copy of the report in this app, yes or no? I consider it a good idea, at least most of the time, allowing unchecking all this, because this is the app that is should be used as the main object. An app should be used to distribute your content across the organization and uncheck basically everything, because other if you, sometimes you maybe face issues that you are not aware of and create that people are creating measures that are not that maybe that familiar as you are creating these measures, and then they create wrong figures, and this can be lead to a lot of confusion inside your department, your colleagues, whatever. Uncheck this, please. Use apps for distribution. There's something next to that. The type of sharing was this one here. So I just came to a conclusion. I was a little bit in advance, or a little bit hasty, let's say. My recommendation is use apps instead of artifact sharing. If you have to share, do not make it your default of distributing your knowledge or insight throughout your colleagues. Do not make it the default. And never ever use publish to web. There's also quite often a question between colleagues, no, not colleagues, at least not for quite some time now, but because I'm also answering questions in the community.powerbi.com, quite often I read the question, how can I share content with colleagues for free? And if you do not want sharing your PBIX file, because the PBIX file is a design thing, maybe you can also consider your Power BIX file as the source code of of your Power BI solution. You do not want to share this, but I want to share it for free. Of course, there is one way where you can share content for free. And this is when you use the publish to web function. It's easy. Go to my great report. Sorry. Opening this report. Takes a while. I can create a publish to web, let's say. Hit this, get a link, blah, blah, blah. I get a link to this report. And because I do not read what's written here, I just hit this create embed code. So another warning and things like that. I just hit publish. What? And now I have a link to this report. So now if I provide you this link, you are able to access this report and without the need for any license. To be precise, this link does not point. Does not point to this report. It points to a copy outside of my workspace. This publishing to web means, this is a report. Publishing to web means a copy of the report will be created, move to another location. Microsoft takes care that data refresh will happen periodically. So data will be maybe not as current as it would be if it's inside, resides in a workspace. And it's a copy, meaning in an instance. So, and it's accessing it is free. So this maybe is a good thing if you share publicly available data. If you want to share publicly available data, then everyone is able to use this and see it. But everyone who has access to this link, and there are quite clever people who also are scanning this link, this one here. Did I copy the link? I'm not sure. I did not copy it. This was stupid. Sorry. I have to reopen once again. Sorry for that. Going to my in private browser, pasting the link, ta-da, accessing this. I'm in private. I did not authenticate. So everyone who has this link is able to see your data. If it's not that important to you, then this is the only one where you are able to share, or the only possibility to share your content for free. Unfortunately, it's not just your colleagues that you send an email, okay, here's a link, you can access it. It's basically to everyone who has access to this, let's say, URL. And for this reason, I think it's not a good idea to use publish to web, except you know exactly what you are doing. And with that, I'm done with this session. So I'm now, please feel free to ask your questions if there are any. So thank you very much for attending.
Thanks so much. This was really insightful. So even after a few years daily working with Power BI, there are still a lot of secrets hidden somewhere underneath the layers of documentation and everything.
Exactly.
There is a quick question from Andrea here in the chat.
Oh, so I start with the question, may I know how I can unpublish the same publish to web? So this is not that simple, because it's not an unpublished. Yes, it's possible. It's somehow, actually, I do not know where it is right now. This is unfortunately, you can manage somehow there's a function. I'm just not see it right now. Maybe it's here. No, it's not. So it's possible to manage the the links that have been created, and just by deleting one of these links, it will be unpublished. It takes a while because suddenly this process sees it's not there any longer, then it will be deleted. So this is not an unpublish, it's deleting the link, but unfortunately I'm currently not able to see where I'm able to manage these.
I think it's under manage permissions, but there is a tab on top, direct access. Is it no?
No, it's not.
It was this there is,
this
somewhere.
Is, this is not. So somewhere it's there. Manage embed code is the is the thing, but I can't find it. So the answer is yes, but it's not an unpublish, it's deleting the link. So the second question is okay, so you have it. Perfect. So I have the possibility to share an artifact that, let's say, for 3.5 years. And now this question from Andrea, can admins check whether their users did publish reports to web? There are now API calls that exactly allow this. And it's also important. So these APIs are there. I have to use it. This can be done or used by using creating a little bit SharePoint. So, and where it is right now, it's also important to understand that. Where's my SharePoint? My Power BI, sorry for that. This is wrong. The other one. Now I'm here once again. One of my other favorite topics is about the admin portal. And it's about inside the tenant settings. Somewhere. Publish to web, it's here, export and sharing your settings. So because inside my little tenant, there are just 3 active users and all of them, it's me. So it's enabled for the entire organization. But maybe you consider it to disable it or restrict it. And also, only allow existing codes and things like that, or you want to just allow for specific security groups. So I can assume that it's important to being able to publish to web. Maybe if you are a public listed company, then maybe you just want to add this Power BI report to your website, and you want everyone who's able to access the website also being able to see your financial figures, because it's publicly available information. But just allow a certain group of people using this feature. And this is what my recommendation is: just allow a certain group of users using to use this function, and educate these users. What does it mean? What does it mean, publish to web? Meaning every single user who is has access, somehow found this link, is able to use this, tell them that what it means. Row level, you can't use a data set or a report that is using a data set where row level security is implemented. You can't, because there is no authentication process accessing these kind of reports. So you have to be sure that your users are aware of certain kind of limitations. And sometimes maybe also this can be sometimes people think creating a bar chart is a security feature. A bar chart, a security feature, what exactly? What? So I just want to demonstrate you a certain thing. Just create a simple report. Create a bar chart, adding a value, adding something, so it's the discount amount, so and it's discount amount for years. This is not fancy, right? So but of course, if I go here, export the data, and then also the underlying data will be exported. The data that is not just visible inside the report, and this is also more important, show as a table, and now somehow there's this function. So that somehow, this is of course not true what I was telling. This is a feature inside the Power BI service that I'm getting asked. Export the underlying data or not, or just the summarized data. Summarized data means a record or a data set will, a CSV file will be created containing three records. Year 2007, 8, and 9, and the values. If I'm doing this inside the Power BI service, then I'm getting asked, it includes the underlying data, and then I get also the details. So just by creating this one here is you have to, what I was trying to say, if you publish your data, make sure that use the function publish to web, make sure that is no hidden gems inside your data set that you do not want to reveal. So and then I guess Andrea is typing. Hopefully I answered the question. Wondering. Okay. I would say yes, you should activate the audit logs. Yes, I'm a great fan of the audit logs. Thank you for pointing this out. But it's also maybe a security feature service that you are maybe have to pay for. So yes, please activate. If you have the possibility, yes, please activate the audit logs. Thank you for this hint. I did forget to mention that. So yes. I love that. I love that. Yes, train. You need this feature is beneficial, adding value, but train your users and make it clear what is their responsibility. And it's also a good idea to consider what you are owning. If you are owning the platform but not the data, so then I can enable, disable certain features by using the Power BI tenant settings. And if the workspace owner is a different people, so then you have to make sure that these people are aware of certain things, but then it's not your, let's say, responsibility. It still will be your fault because it's coming from the platform you own, but maybe it makes discussions a little bit more simple. So if there are no questions anymore, then thank you so much, Austin, for inviting me. To everyone attending this session, if there are questions, I will share the presentation tomorrow. I guess also if you want to have the slides, I'll send you an email and then thank you very much.
Thank you, Thomas. It was a pleasure hosting you and listening to a lot of interesting things. Most of us tend to forget sometimes.
Yes, this is
going back to them. And it was a great. Great seeing you and hosting you. Also, thanks to everybody who spent time with us again this week. And just a short announcements on a closing. So next week, we are again with Chris Wagner and 1st of December with Michael Kowalski. So lots of interesting sessions coming in. And also, as we placed on the beginning, as always, join us on 22nd of December. We are closing the year with great speakers. So Jeffrey Wang, Matthew Roche, Melissa Coates, Pratik Amasani, and Nikola Ilic are joining us. We will have a panel discussion and it will be great fun and lots of insights. So thank you again. I wish everybody a good evening or the good rest of the day, depends from where you are joining. And thank you again for joining us. And thank you, Thomas, for sharing the knowledge with us.
Of course. And I guess we see hear us again on Saturday.
On Saturday, of course. So Power BI Fest is this Saturday. So whoever wants to join, feel Please. Free to join.
So then have a great evening and stay safe.
Thank you. Have a nice evening. Great. Bye.
Bye.